Francis.
Julian March is doing a show!
First audition's 10 a.m. tomorrow.
But we've got the whole weekend.
All right, let's have those names and addresses.
Phyllis Dale, 156 South 47th Street.
Lorraine Fleming, same address as her.
Diane Lorimar, 333 Park Avenue.
Oh, and I bet she gets a little behind in her rent.
Well, look who's here. It's Ann Riley. Why, you remember Ann Riley, don't you?
Anytime, Annie. Who could forget her? She only said no once, and then she
did it. Hey, Ethel, it must have been tough on your mother not having any children.
Hey,
quiet! All of you! We're doing a show, damn it, and anybody who doesn't want this job, the nearest bread line's around the corner. All right, now get those names and addresses.
All right, let's have them. Looking for somebody?
The dance director. I'm here to get into the show.
Oh, well, you're a little late. They've already picked the chorus. You should have been here at 10.
Oh, I was, but it took me nearly an hour to get up enough courage to go through the stage door. You're not Mr. Marsh, are you?
Billy Lawler, one of Broadway's better juveniles. Well, say, I bet you're new to show business.
Oh, I've had experience.
Well, how many shows?
Any number of them.
Such as?
This would have been my first if they'd taken me.
Well, I'd take you any day. Well, say, how about lunch?
Oh, no, I've got to see the dance director.
Okay, then dinner. Or lunch tomorrow?
Oh, that's very kind of you, but I really must see the dance director.
I know a bundle of humanity. She's about so high. I'm nearly driven to insanity when she passes by. She's a sunny little honey, but oh, so hard to kiss. I'll try to overcome her vanity, and then I'll tell her this. I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do? If I could hate ya, I'd keep away. But that ain't my nature, I'm full of vitamin A. Say, well, say, I've got an idea. You're not going to get Andy Lee to audition you unless she's got no choice.
Oh,
well, come with me.
Oh, come on.
You know the songs, don't you?
Yes, but that's...
Okay, kid, go to it.
What?
Your first notes on Broadway.
Oh, my.
What are you looking for?
I don't like scarf. I wore it when I was elected Miss Allentown and Miss Junior Elk.
Come on, kid, sing. I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms. I'm young and healthy, and so are you. When the moon is in the sky, tell me, what am I to do?
If I could just...
I'd keep away. But that ain't my nature. I'm full of vitamin A.
Say,
I'm young and healthy, so let's be bold. In a year or two or three, maybe we will be too old.
Take it from the top, Olive.
I'm young and healthy, and you've got charms. It would really be a sin not to have you in my arms.
Hold it! Hold it, Olive! Who's helped you to sing?
It was my idea, Andy.
That's a pretty fresh idea. You beat it.
Oh, come on. Give her a break, Andy. She's great.
Andy, Mr. Marsh is here. I just saw the taxi pull up.
Mr. Marsh is here. I've got no time for breaks.
And scraped.
Don't go. I'll talk to Julian myself.
But I don't want to get you into any trouble.
I said, beat it.
All right, I'm going.
At least give me your name.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't think...
What the hell was that?
She wanted to get into the line, Bob.
Ours are Notre Dame's. All right, everybody, gather around and listen to me. Today, we start work on a new show. We're going to rehearse for 4 weeks and then try out in Atlantic City. You're going to dance 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. You're going to dance until your feet fall off and you aren't able to stand up anymore. But 5 weeks from today, Pretty Lady's going to be the best show this town's ever seen. You're on your way to glory and $32 a week. So anyone who doesn't think he can take it, you better quit right now. Nobody? Good. Now take a half hour to get measured for wigs and costumes, and let's go to work.
You may costumes downstairs. Get a move on.
Somebody left this purse on the piano.
Oh, it must be hers. The kid Annie threw out. Is there anything in it?
About 40 cents and a card.
Peggy Sawyer, 137 Elm Street, Allentown, PA. You run along to your fitting and I'll see that she gets it.
Gotcha.
Julian, that was a great speech you gave and you won't regret a word of it. Pretty Lady's the best show we've ever written.
Now with the greatest director on Broadway.
Save the soft soap, Bert. I need the show as much as you do.
Wall Street got you, too?
You know the old saying, there's a horse's ass for every light on Broadway. I've given all I had to that glittering gulch out there, and it's been a hell of a ride. Okay, so the crash put me down for the count. But I'm still Julian Marsh, damn it. And Pretty Lady's gonna put me back on top.
That's right.
Let's talk about the cast.
Best in town, Billy Lawler for the juvenile.
Me and Maggie for character parts.
And Dorothy Brock in the lead.
It's Brock I'm worried about. Her last hit was 10 years ago.
We have to use her, Julian. She's got Abner Dillon in her back pocket.
You know, Dillon's kitty cars. He's agreed to put up the whole 100,000 if she's the star.
But she can't dance.
Put a lot of girls around her, let her wave her arms a lot. The public will never know the difference.
I don't know, Maggie.
Easy, Marsh. Here she comes. Dorothy, Maggie.
Don't say a word. I want to do this one by myself. Mr. Marsh, ever since I was a tiny little girl and saw my first Julian Marsh show, I have dreamed of the day when I might work with the King of Broadway. At last, that day has come, and I am filled with pride, joy, and humility.
Thanks, Miss Brock. Feeling a little full myself. Now, before we go any further, I'd like to try you out on one of the numbers.
Hold on, Mr. Marsh. Dorothy don't have to try out. She's already got her contract.
Mr. Dillon, what would I do without you? Oh, and by the way, there were a few items you forgot to mention, so I wrote them in. Limousine, redecorated dressing room, private maid. No problem about the salary. I just added another zero.
Now see here, Dorothy.
Of course. If anyone objects, I won't insist. We'll just go peddle our kitty cars, and you go peddle your fish.
You're not hearing me, Miss Brock. I just want to hear you on one of the songs, to see if you can handle the role.
If you are asking me to audition, Mr. Marsh, I'm afraid the answer is no.
It's not an audition, Dorothy. He just wants to see if it's in the right key.
Try the new one we went over yesterday. You'll love it. Bert and I see you in this low-down dive, and the piano pounds out a hot jazz beat, and you enter and sing, shadows on the wall, I can see them fall, here and there, everywhere, silhouettes in blue, dancing in the dew, here am I, oh baby, where are you?
That's fine, Maggie.
In the shadows, let me come sing to you.
That's fine. Thank you. All right, Olive, play in three-quarter time for Miss Brock.
Julian, we
and
that.
Down at tone. Miss Brock, from the top. From the top, Miss Brock.
Shadows on the wall. I can't see them fall. Here am I. Where are you?
All right, that's fine. Matt, Andy.
Yeah, Matt?
I want two shin busters. One right and one left.
Yeah,
Miss Brock, please put this on. Frankie, yeah. See if you got a scrim on 28. Bring it in.
Let me take these.
All right, Olive, from the top of the course, nice and easy. Kill the work lights. Miss Brock, if you please.
In the shadows, let me come and sing.
It's all right. Look straight front.
To you. Let me sing a song that I can sing. Got ya.
I've got you. Look behind you.
Oh. To you, take me in your arms and let me cling to you. Let me linger long, let me live my song. In the winter, let me bring spring to you. Let me know that I'm in everything to you. Love's old song will be new. In the shadows when I come and sing, in the shadows when I come and sing, In the shadows, in the shadows.
Not bad.
Mr. Marsh, what does it take to get a compliment out of you?
That was a compliment, Miss Brock.
Wardrobe, where are you? How do you expect me to dance when these sleeves are halfway to the ground?
Hello, kid.
Pat, what are you doing here?
I had to see some booking agents in the neighborhood.
I thought I'd drop by and see my best girl.
And what if Mr. Dillon had been here? No, Pat, it's too dangerous. Now, be a dear and take in a picture or something, and I'll meet you in my dressing room at 5.
Darling, I can't take your money. It was all right in the old days when we had the vaudeville act together, but now you're a star.
Oh, what difference does that make if we still care for each other? Don't you think I hate meeting in all corners like this? But isn't it better than not meeting at all? In the winter, let me bring the spring to you. Let me know that I mean everything to you. Now run along, dearest. Come meet you in my dressing room at 5.
Dorothy, I...
Till 5, darling.
Come on, girls. We've only got an hour for lunch. Hey, kid, you left this purse on the piano.
Oh, thank you, Miss...
Jones, Maggie Jones.
Thank you very much.
And don't worry, the bankroll's intact. You look like you could use some grub. How about putting in a feed bag with me and the girls?
Oh, no, I don't think I could.
Not another word about it. It's all taken care of.
Say, kid, I've been looking all over for you. Well, how about lunch now?
Oh, I'm sorry. I just promised to eat lunch with Miss Jones and the girls.
Would you like to join us?
No, thank you. I'm looking for a mouthful, not an earful. But I'll tell you what, I'll give you a rain check.
What makes tenors such wolves?
I think it's that tight underwear they wear.
Hey. No, girls. That's what makes them tenors. Now, come along. I'm taking you to the lovely place with all the windows.
The after-roof?
The automat. All right, the gypsy tea kettle. But I don't want to waste any time, so you're going to dance your way over there.
But I don't know your steps.
Well, if you think you can pick them up, I can show them to you.
Okay.
All right. Now with a pullback. Hey, kid, you're good.
I know.
All right, let's put it all together now. One, two, three.
Of boiling water and one tea bag.
How about some gravy?
No, thank you. There's enough on the tablecloth. We'll have five combination dinner plates and get the lead out. We're heavy tippers. So, Peggy, you still want to get into show business after today?
More than ever. Imagine someday dancing on the same stage as Dorothy Brock.
I can understand how she feels. My grandmother felt the same way.
I don't know how you can say that. Dorothy's worked very hard to get where she is. I remember on her first show, she earned $30 a week and sent $100 home to her mother.
Let's face it, the only thing that girl has over any of us at this table is Abner Dillon.
Who's he?
Her sugar daddy.
Oh, her father.
You can't be just 21. Nobody can get that dumb in just 21 years.
Kid, we're gonna have to teach you the Broadway facts of life.
Oh, don't worry about me. I learned all about men in Allentown.
Eugene O'Neill would have given his eye teeth to have written that line.
Should we tell her about the musicians?
All she needs to know is they keep them in a pit, and it's for a good reason.
I still wish I were in the show with you.
Oh, if not this one, the next. You're a looker and you can chirp like a bird. And you're pretty hot stuff in the steps department. You hoofers are the luckiest ones in the business. So what if you had a little trouble this AM? You've got all you need to cheer you up right there at the end of your ankles. If you've a melancholy case of the blues, I've got a remedy for you. If there's an ounce of rhythm down in your shoes, then I'll change your point of view. If you've been singing a sad and blue song, go into your depths until you learn how to sing a new song. Go into your depths. Don't be complaining. Smile, and if it's raining, dance in the rain a while. Put off your sorrows until tomorrow. Go into your
dance.
busting my brains out to put on a show they'll pay good money to see, and you're giving it away free on the streets. You kids get back in there. This is great, just great.
Is this something wrong, boss?
Wrong. We're short one girl, that's what's wrong.
Well, you told me to pick two dozen.
Just one for good measure. I always choose one for good measure. Don't give me your excuses. Just get me another girl.
I could have one here first thing in the morning.
Well, that's just ducky. And I'm supposed to block the boardwalk scene this afternoon. You know, I've got a mind to go to the first girl I see. Just walk up to the first dame that passes on the streets and say, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you. Can you dance?
I'm from Allentown, Pennsylvania, and I can do any dance you've ever invented. Wings, crumbles,
all right, relax, Allentown. Hey, you've got the job. Okay, Andy, take her in there and get her ready to rehearse. Hey, wait a minute. Aren't you that Mack truck that tried to run me down this morning?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't know it was you. It'll never happen again, I swear, on my mother, my father, my
aunt. All right, take it easy, kid. I kind of enjoyed it. Now get in there and start learning those numbers. We've got a show to do.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh.
Did you get those kids into costume?
Yeah, boss.
Good, now get me Brock and Billy. I want to run the boardwalk scene with the dialogue.
No, Mr. Brock, we can't run the dance section. Gladys is out with a cold.
Then use Winnie.
Winnie? We can't use Winnie. She's in the number before. She'll never make the change.
Then just get me any girl. We'll put a costume on her later. I want her in the scene now. Brock, Billy, let's go! All right, it is morning. The sun sparkles brightly on a section of the boardwalk in Atlantic City. As we discover Rodney and Madeline, Madeline speaks.
Darling, darling, why did you take so long to declare yourself? The answer is yes, of course. We'll live together in a cottage by the sea, and every morning we'll have breakfast and kisses in bed. Oh, please.
And Rodney says?
And will you always love me, Madeline?
Yes, 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 yes. Yes.
Now, Rodney declares his love and they kiss.
Hold on a minute! What's that fella doing to Dorothy?
I was only acting, Mr. Dillon.
I don't care what you call it. I ain't putting up good money to see the lady I love kissed by no actor.
All right, all right, all right, cut the kiss. Just say the speech and improvise something.
My darling, I love you. I worship you. I adore you.
I don't know exactly how it started, but it started in fun. I just wanted someone to stay with, to play with someone. But now I realize that I could never let you go, and I've come to tell you so. Every kiss, every hug seems to act just like a drug. You're getting to be a habit with me. Let me stay in your arms. I'm addicted to your charms. You're getting to be a habit with me. I used to think your love was something that I could take or leave alone. But now I couldn't do without my supply. I need you for my own. Oh, I can't stay away. I must have you every day, as regularly as coffee or tea. You've got me in your clutches and I can't break free. You're getting to be a habit with me.
Thank you.
Are you okay, kid? Whoa, she's fainted.
Thank God.
Well, it's not Peggy's fault. She didn't eat anything for lunch.
All right, Billy, Mac, take her into Brock's dressing room. The rest of you, this is still a rehearsal. Andy, I want him to clean up those last 16 bars before the pivot.
Kids fainted. Par for the course on a Julian Marsh show. You, go get her some water, will ya? And you'd better get back out there before the boss starts yelling for you.
All right, but when she comes to, tell her I'll be back as soon as I get a chance. The name's Lawler. Billy Lawler?
Yeah, come on, Lawler.
You okay, kid?
I guess I fainted.
Good guess.
But I guess I'm all right now.
Whoa, bad guess. Oh. Well, you need some rest right now.
But the rehearsal isn't over.
Yes, it is, young lady, for you at least. Now, let me be the doctor for a while. And as your doctor, my first prescription is for you to sit in this chaise. All right? My second prescription is for you to get these legs up.
And I bet I know what your third prescription is.
Darling, I wasn't expecting you until 5.
Oh, it's quite obvious you weren't expecting me. Doctor.
Well, darling, she fainted, and they brought her in here until she came to.
And since when is my dressing room an emergency ward for every clumsy corin who throws a little fainting act?
Now you get her out of here before I prescribe some medication she won't like so much.
Darling.
You shut up! And if my prescription upsets you, Doctor, then you can just get out with her.
What the hell's going on in here? I'm trying to have rehearsal on that stage. Who are you?
My name is Pat Denning, Mr. Marsh. I was a guest of Miss Brock's.
Well, beat it. Miss Brock's official gentleman friend happens to be in the house.
Official?
And I don't want him to get any funny ideas.
Dorothy!
It's Abner. Pat, quick, behind the screen.
Stay where you are. Come right in, Mr. Dillon. We're just having a little script conference.
Hello, Sugar Plum.
I just bought these posies for you.
Thank you.
I hope I wasn't interrupting anything.
No, not at all. We were just winding up. By the way, Mr. Dillon, this is one of our dancers, Peggy Sawyer, and her boyfriend, Pat Denny.
Now, just a minute,
Say, Mr. Dillon, do you realize it's your fault that this conference is breaking up?
My fault?
Yes. Dorothy said she didn't want to go on any further, because she wanted to be alone with you.
Do you mean that, Dorothy?
Of course I mean it. What girl wouldn't want to be alone with you? Just look at yourself. Come on.
Mr. Denny, your presence in this dressing room has caused a great deal of unnecessary turmoil, and I suggest that such visits do not occur again. And Mr. Denny, this kid's a pretty good hoofer, and I don't want to lose her to the price of a bowl of chili. Take her out and get her something to eat. Please have a word with you.
Of course, Julian. Is it about the character I'm playing?
No, actually, it's about the character you're playing around with. Look, I don't know what went on in that dressing room, but Pretty Lady means far too much to me to let any gigolo stand in its way. I want you to give him up.
Aren't you a bit confused, Julian? You're the director of my show, not my personal life.
When your personal life gets in the way of my show, I direct that too.
Mr. Marsh, I shall see whom I please when I please. And no show is going to stand in my way.
Bert, I think we've got ourselves a bit of a problem. And I think I've got myself a little solution. Hello, Nick Murphy, please.
Murphy? He's a killer!
Look, if you don't like the song, just say so.
I put a girlfriend of his in my last show. He owes me a favor. Hello, Nick. Julian Marsh. Yes, I'm calling about a bit of a problem I'm having. Yes, there's this guy I've been hanging around to rehearsals by the name of Pat Denning. And I was hoping maybe you could send a couple of boys over to persuade him to make himself scarce for the next couple of weeks. Right. Thanks a lot, Nick. Pleasure doing business with you. And that, I believe, is the end of that.
Julian, I just got a call from Atlantic City. They've canceled our booking. But everything's all right. We picked up a week at the Art Street Theater in Philadelphia.
Philadelphia? But all our shows have opened in Atlantic City.
Maybe Philly will change your luck.
He's right.
Let's get packing. I'm grabbing my hat and coat.
I'm leaving the cat a note.
Quick, call me a ferry boat getting out of town.
I'm sorry I couldn't take you any place fancier, but the old purse strings are a bit frayed at the moment.
You know a guy named Pat Denning?
Yeah?
We got a little message for him. He better lay off this Brockdam or it's gonna be too bad for him. Get it?
I'll make sure and tell him.
This is so you don't forget.
Pat, who were they?
Friends with some good advice.
Hey, you at the company?
Yeah.
I'd like to leave a message for Miss Dorothy Brock. Tell her that Pat Denning has joined a stock company in Philadelphia and won't be back for at least 6 months with no forwarding address. I'm shining my traveling shoes. Big scoop in the Daily News. Who's saying his toodaloo's getting out of town?
I'm sorry, but I don't want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must play out of town in Atlantic City.
Message for you, Miss Brock. Bell left it last night.
But Dorothy, why don't you want to go to Philadelphia?
Who says I don't want to go to Philadelphia? I want to go to Philadelphia. My contract says I must play out of town in Philadelphia.
To get him aboard. That dress rehearsal starts at 8 o'clock sharp. So let's get moving.
All right.
My neighbors are awful nice. They brought her to me the mice. And I spend a meter lights getting out of town. There's a running on my life. We're shouting.
Now it's up to you to see that we get out of here alive. There are 24 musicians and one director down in this pit, just dying to go on overtime. So let's get this dress rehearsal started. And another thing, not all the scenery and costumes have arrived yet. So we'll be adding things as we go along. So don't let it throw you. Frome, we're late. Let's go.
I can't hear my first note. Mac, please!
Quiet!
Thank you. Okay, I got it.
Who writes the words and music for all the girly shows? No one can. Some villain always frames, but who cares if there's a plot or not when they've got a lot of games. What do you go for? Go see a show for. Tell the truth, you go to see those beautiful dames. You spend your dough for bouquets that grow for all those cute and cunning young and beautiful dames. Dames are temporary blames to you. Dames, you don't recall their names, do you? But their caresses and home addresses linger in your memory of those beautiful, in your memory, see those beautiful, in your memory, all those beautiful days.
This show, Julian, and I don't appreciate being brought in 10 seconds before the blackout.
Well, are you suggesting I bring you in after the blackout?
I am suggesting that you redo this number and suit it to my talents.
Well, that might make it a rather short number, Miss Brock.
You'll regret that remark, Mr. Marsh. You may be the director of this show, but I'm driving the kitty car.
All right, the rest of you, listen to me. I want you all to go out and relax and forget about Pretty Lady until tomorrow. But then I want you to come back here and give the performance of your lives. Company dismissed. I'll meet you at the stage door.
Are you coming to the party, Mr. Marsh?
Huh?
To the Regency Club. Miss Jones and Mr. Barry just invited everyone. Is something funny?
You are. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas, dreaming of parties and opening nights, the tinsel and glitter of musical comedy. Just look at yourself. You're nothing but a speck of dust on this stage. Indistinguishable from the 40 other specks of dust I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. But if you put all of those specks together, they create something alive and beautiful that can reach out to 1,000 people we've never seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Andy, where the hell are you?
I'm right here, boss. I've got all the notes typed out, all 7 pages.
Look, the notes can wait. I've decided to take some of my own advice and forget about Pretty Lady until tomorrow. Come on, let's go dream a little.
Figured out what the show needs. A few more songs by Irving Berlin. Get away from me. Take Buffalo Bill with you.
Hey, wait a minute. I've got $100,000 in this show, so you'd better not give me the air.
So I'd better not give you the air, huh? Well, how about just a few bubbles? Now get on your kitty car and pedal back to Tulsa, you beached whale.
Oh, don't pay any attention to her. She's all excited. Opening night and everything.
There ain't gonna be an opening night. Not with Dorothy Brock. She's out of the show.
Brock will open tomorrow as scheduled. But don't be a fool, Dylan. Do you want to throw away all that money because of a dame?
It's my funeral, ain't it?
And the funeral of half a 100 kids who've been dancing their feet up to give you a show you could be proud of. Do you want to put them on the streets, too?
You wouldn't do that to us, Mr. Dylan, would you?
Not after we put all our faith in you.
But you called me a whale and a cobra.
Listen, in show business, that's a compliment. Now, what you need is some fun. Why don't you come along over here and I'll sing you the scores of my last 6 shows.
I don't care how many hotels you've tried. Try the Belvedere, too. And now.
I don't know what's gotten into her. She was fine this afternoon.
I smell a rat, Bert. And that rat's initials are Pat Denny.
Hello, Belvedere. Have you a Pat Denning there? You do. Well, give him to me, you idiot.
Hey, boss, it's Flo at the switchboard. She's an old friend of mine, and she just told me Dorothy Brock's been calling all over town to get Pat Denning.
So I was right. Denning is in town.
Oh, Pat, darling, I can't take it anymore. I can't. I've tried to forget you, but I can't, so please, come back at once. At once.
Hey, Peggy, how about the next dance?
In a minute, Billy.
What are we gonna do about Denny, boss?
Call Nick Murphy. I think he's got a couple of Philadelphia cousins who might be able to handle the situation.
Oh, Pat, I can't take it anymore. I can't.
Darling, will you calm down and tell me what's wrong?
In a minute, just hold me first. Never let me go.
It's all taken care of. Two of the boys will be over in 10 minutes, and they better not find Denning here.
Hey, Peggy, how about that dance now?
I'm sorry, Billy, but a friend of mine is in trouble.
Man friend or a lady friend?
A man, but Billy, he...
It's okay, Peggy.
No, Billy, I
get it. Not anymore. Come on, let's have some fun.
Who is it?
Peggy Sawyer, Miss Brock.
Peggy. The fainting violet Mr. Denning took out to dinner last week.
I've got to see Pat. Pat, there's going to be trouble.
You're darn right there is, unless you get out of here.
Wait a minute, Dorothy.
What is it, Peggy?
Two men, friends of Murphy.
Don't tell me to wait a minute. And how come you're sticking up for her in the first place?
Darling, you don't understand.
I think I understand all too well.
No, you don't.
Get out of here, the both of you.
But Miss Brock,
it's all right, Peggy. Now, Dorothy.
I said the both of you.
All right. If that's the way you want it.
That's the way I want it. Get out! Out! He's the only one. I know now I'm the lonely one. I had to learn how a heart can yearn, how tears can burn with no one to turn to. I know now that I can't forget. I can't, for I don't know how. I guess I never knew how I needed you. But sweetheart, I know. I can't, for I don't know how. I guess I never knew how I needed you. But sweetheart,
sweetheart, sweetheart, but sweetheart, I know
for long unless we speed up these scene changes. Mac, where the hell's that cue?
We're just waiting for the girls to get into place, Mr. Marsh.
Girls?
All right, there they are. Let's go.
All right, 264, go!
You got it! I got
it! Pat, hold on before the gas falls off! Watch out for the scissors, Grady! I got it!
What is it, a panic?
I need to go home to a horse as I gotta rub the dirt off!
We're in the money. We're in the money. We're going.
going, Julian?
Like a Marsh show should. Great. But this is the scene that counts. We send them out for the intermission buzzing, and that's the ball game.
Then we've got nothing to worry about. This is the best scene in the whole show.
Well, it won't be unless Brock gets out here. Dorothy, where the hell are you?
No need to shout, Julian. I can hear you.
Well, you're on in about 10 seconds.
I have never missed a cue in my life. When I do, you can take me to task, but not before.
Miss Brock, come on, why don't you explain about
life? I don't want an explanation from you.
No, Miss Brock.
Just get away from me. The further, the better.
You're on. All right, everybody, Q68, go!
You'll find a thoroughfare. It's the part of little old New York that runs into Times Square. A crazy quilt that Wall Street Jack built. If you've got a little time to spare, I want to take you there. Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to.
Marshall, you're fired! Can I please have your attention? Dorothy Brock has had an accident and will not be able to continue tonight's performance of Pretty Lady. Ladies and gentlemen, your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights.
Well, Doc, what is it?
I'm afraid it's broken, a hairline fracture. It'll be months before she'll be able to walk again.
Are you nuts? She's got a show to do tomorrow night.
She's a trooper. Put Yates' bandage on her.
You don't seem to understand. Miss Brock has a broken ankle. She won't even be able to stand up.
Well, get another doctor. A second
opinion. Quiet. All of you, look, we have no star. And without a star, we have no show.
Julian.
Don't give me excuses. No star, no show. Tell the kids to clear out their dressing rooms.
Pretty Lady closes tonight.
Do you realize what you're saying?
Dylan, you can't be serious after all.
Someone in this company with that much talent. Don't you think I would have noticed her?
Maybe not in this case.
We're wasting our time.
All you have to do is give her a chance. Isn't anything better than closing the show?
All right, who is she?
Peggy Sawyer.
That kid?
That kid's got a voice that'll panic him and she can dance friends around Frost.
She's a raw beginner. This is her first job in the chorus.
No, wait, boss. She is the best dancer in the line.
That's not carrying a show. Look, Brock is such an easy performer, she's fooled you. That sort of style takes years of experience to develop.
Unless the kid's got it naturally, which she just might have.
Learn? Not to mention the dances and routines.
She's a kid. She can do anything.
We can put the dancing back in the show, boss.
It's worth a try, isn't it?
All right, send her in.
There's only one hitch. You just fired her.
Oh, but it may not be too late to get her back. She's taking 11:10 to Allentown. That gives us 20 minutes to get down to Broad Street Station.
What are we gonna do, boss?
I want her off that train. I want so you're in New York, ready to rehearse at 8 o'clock sharp.
Ain't we gonna stay here in Philadelphia?
And lose $10,000 a night? Our only chance is to ship the show to New York, beat the part into her in 36 hours, and open cold on Thursday. Now get going. No, wait a minute. This is my job. I fired her. It's up to me to get her back.
Julian, I can go.
I said I'll go. Thanks, Annie.
You may have done me quite a favor.
Any time, Mr. Marsh. Any time.
Oh. Now we give him 15 minutes, then we bring in the big gun.
Yeah.
Not easy being fired.
You did me a favor, Mr. Marsh. Oh, it may not have been easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer. And that's just what I'm going to do.
I'm here to apologize for what happened and to ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr. Marsh.
And take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. Her ankle's broken, and she's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What was that word you just said? Allentown? I'm offering you the chance to star in the biggest musical Broadway has seen in over 20 years, and you say, Allentown? Now listen, Sawyer, and listen good. Even if you don't care about me, think of all the kids you'll be throwing on the streets if you don't do this. Think of all the songs that will wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the costumes never worn, the scenery never seen, the orchestrations never heard. Think of Pretty Lady and the thrill and pleasure she could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway, damn it!
Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway, the hip hooray and ballyhoo, the lullaby of Broadway, the rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. When a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning. Manhattan babies don't sleep tight until the dawn. Good night, baby. Good night. The milkman's on his way. Sleep tight, baby. Sleep tight, let's call it a day. Listen to the lullaby of old Broadway. To the lullaby of Broadway. The lullaby of Broadway. The band begins to go to town, and everyone goes crazy. You rock and buy your baby round, till everything gets hazy. As you buy, I'll buy you this and that. You hear a dad. And maybe goes home to her flat to sleep all day. Good night, baby.
of taxis, the daffodils who entertain.
You won't regret it, Julian.
Why did we gamble the show on a beginner like this?
She's the best we've got.
She's late.
Yeah?
Sawyer, you're 2 minutes late.
Sorry, Mr. Marsh, I was looking for my good luck scarf.
Sawyer, this curtain goes up in exactly 36 hours. You've got 25 pages, 6 songs, and 10 dance routines to learn by 8:30 tomorrow night. Do you think you can do it?
Do you think
you can do it, Sawyer?
Yes, Mr. Marsh, I can.
Good, then let's get going. Mac, where the hell's that piano? Get in, Mr. Marsh. All right, we're going to start with the top number, work through all the dances and scenes, then go back and do the dialogue. There'll be a 5-minute break every hour for food or coffee, and a full 15 minutes every 4 hours for rest. And no one else on the stage until I call. By 8:30 tomorrow night, I'll either have a live leading lady or a dead chorus girl. Now let's get going.
All right, Peggy, slaps on the right foot. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes, ma'am.
Smile, Allentown. You're not in the back row now.
All right, Peggy, good work. Down the back.
Pick him up. Pick him up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
That's it, show Moxie.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, good.
Lyrical, elegant.
All right, Peggy, good, Peggy. Lift it up.
Make every man fall in love. All right, Annie, where the hell is she?
She's right here, boss, hold your horses. Out from the balance, please. Girls, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Annie, she went too wide. Very nice, very nice.
All right, Peggy, turn. Turn.
Left, right, just do it like you mean it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, lift it up.
That's it, single step, going back. Good. Coming up on the dip. Everyone dip,
Peggy.
Out.
Okay, good. Annie, give the rest of them a break. I want her in the love scene.
All right, everybody, down in the lounge. Get a move on!
Marsh, I'm exhausted. Can't we stop for a minute?
Sawyer, this curtain goes up in exactly 2 hours. It's now or never. Now take it from Jim's entrance. What are you waiting for from Jim's entrance?
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
No. Look, you're greeting the man you love. Make it mean something. Like this. Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come. Now say the line.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Look, have you ever been in love? Have you ever had a man take in his arms and crush you to him and kiss you? Now say the line.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
Again.
Jim. They didn't tell me you were here. It was grand of you to come.
One more time. I had to. The curtain goes up in 45 minutes.
Find you here.
Miss Brock.
Pat, leave us alone.
Is this the time for this, Dorothy? They've already called half hour.
I've got some things I'd like to say to Miss Sawyer. So, you're taking my place.
I'm sorry. I know how hard it must be.
Do you? I'm not so sure. When I started for the theater this afternoon, I wanted to tear your heart out. I wanted to hate you. I wanted to see you fail. You, singing my songs, wearing my costumes, playing my role. But sitting in that theater and watching you rehearse, I found I couldn't hate you. Because you're good. Maybe even better than I would have been. The public wants youth, freshness, beauty. And Peggy, that's what you've got. Only I'm getting something too. For 10 years, the theater has kept me away from the only thing I've ever wanted. And it was a broken ankle that made me finally realize it. Pat Denning and I were married this morning.
Oh, Miss Brock.
I only have one last wish for you, dear. And that is that you go out there on that stage tonight and be so wonderful that you'll make me hate you. And Sawyer, one more thing. I hope you won't mind, but it's about the next closing number. You've got to take it easy. Let the audience come to you. Would you let me show you what I mean?
I would appreciate it very much. Dorothy?
to your own. Life begins when you get your guy all alone. From morning until twilight, I don't know I'm alive. But I know love begins at 8:45. The stars are gonna twinkle and shine this evening about 9:15. Around me about 9:45. I know I won't be late, 'cause at 8:30 I'm gonna hurry there. I'll be waiting where the lane begins, waiting for him on needles and pins, and then the world is gonna be mine this evening about 9:15. I know I won't be late, 'cause at 8:30 I'm gonna hurry there. I'll be waiting where the lane begins, waiting for him on needles and pins, and then be mine this evening about 9:15.
Thank you, Miss Brock.
That's not good enough.
I want better than your best. I want sheer, unadulterated brilliance. Now, what are you kids hanging around for? Go get into your places for the opening. Peggy, I want to talk to you.
Julian, you say Ford, we've got to call places.
All right, tell them to take the house to half. Now listen, and listen hard. 100 people, 100 jobs, $100,000, 5 weeks of blood and grind and sweat, and it all depends on what you do out there tonight. Now I know what you're thinking. Here comes Mr. Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last of them, Sawyer. And it comes straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, and our lives are in your hands. Go out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This morning, it was acting. This one, I mean.
Julian, we've got to call places.
All right, I'll be right there. Sawyer, you're going out there a youngster, but you've got to come back a star.
one that you'll adore. I'm gonna take you for a ride. You go home and get your panties.
You go home and get your scannies, and away we'll go.
Ooh, off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle out to Buffalo. To Niagara in the sleeper, there's no honeymoon that's cheaper, and the train goes slow. Ooh, off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle out to Buffalo. Someday the stork may pay a visit and leave a little souvenir, just a little cute, what is it? Well, we'll discuss that later, dear. For a little silver quarter, we can have the Pullman porter turn the lights down low. Ooh, off we're gonna shuffle, shuffle out to Buffalo.
I'm doing more, damn it, I say you will. Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Where the underworld can meet the elite. 42nd Street.
Thank you. Of course she is. Escorted by Mr. Billy Lawler himself.
Billy, you were just swell.
Anytime you want a kitty car, just say the word.
Come along,
we've
got a little party for you at the Ritz.
For me?
We'll see you at the Ritz.
It's so exciting. They all loved the show.
Oh, they all loved you. And that goes double for me.
Billy.
Well, come on. We've got the kids' party to go to.
Oh, gee, Billy, I don't know if I can. What about the party at the Ritz? Billy? Am I really a star?
From now on and forever.
And stars can do anything they want?
Anything.
But I want to go to the kids' party.
Oh, hey.
Oh, Billy, wait a minute.
You haven't changed your mind?
Of course not. I'll be along in a minute. Wait for me at the stage door.
All right, but just 1 minute. You know how impatient tenors are.
Mr. Marsh?
Say, Peggy, what is the matter with me? In all this excitement, I forgot to congratulate you. Congratulations, kid.
Thank you, Mr. Marsh, but you and I both know who is out on that stage tonight. Oh, I said all the lines and did all the steps and sang all the songs. But you were inside of me pulling the strings. So I congratulate you.
You're quite a girl, Miss Peggy Sawyer. Quite a girl. And you're on your way to becoming quite a star. You've broken through, Peggy. You are the one in a million shot that comes home a winner. For years to come, thousands of little chorus girls will be going to auditions and say, who knows, maybe someday I'll be another Peggy Sawyer.
Oh.
I only ask that you'll be the kind of star those little girls want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch they call 42nd Street. Give it your strength, your youth, and your talent. But try, if you can, not to give it all of your heart. Because it's a very loving heart. And I'd hate very much to see it broken. Now go along to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
I'm going to the kids' party.
I was right. You're quite a girl.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night, Allentown. Say, where is the kids' party?
At Lorraine's. The address is on the call board. And Mr. Marsh? It would be grand, 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 if you would come.
Come and meet those dancing feet. On the avenue I'm taking you to. 42nd Street, hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Sexy ladies from the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified. Where the underworld can meet the elite. Naughty, body, gaudy, sporty. Forty.